Hi everyone, today we will make a simple dal fry, and I've got half cup of chana dal and half cup tur dal soaking here. And I won't soak it for too long since I'm using a pressure cooker, and that usually fastens the process, so that's what I have done. I've just soaked it for about 30 minutes. So now let's begin the cooking process, and I have a pressure cooker. And you could use a combination of dals or just one dal or whatever your preference is. But this is about one cup of dal. So yeah, I've started off with my pressure cooker. I've added about 2 tablespoons of ghee in it. And then I'll add my mustard and cumin seeds first. As you can see, I've added 1/4 teaspoon of mustard seeds and half teaspoon of cumin seeds, and I'm wait for them to pop, and then add the other things. See, they're about to pop, and just adding to this. This is a very quick dish, so if you're in a hurry, it's a lovely dish to make, especially when you're coming from work. And it's a nutritious dish. You get your proteins from your dal or lettuce. Once I hear the popping of the cumin and the mustard seeds, I add 1 small diced onion. And I'll add 1 teaspoon of ginger and 1 teaspoon of garlic too. I meant 1 teaspoon of ginger and 1 teaspoon of garlic, because I'm making less dal, which is 1 whole cup of dal. We don't need too much of it. So I'll saute it for a few minutes. I've also added 1 whole red chili, dry red chili in it. You can see I have been stirring it in between so it doesn't stick to the bottom. And when I get light gold, I will start adding the tomatoes. At this point, I will also add the hing, or asafoetida, just 1 or 2 pinches of it, generous pinches of it. You can see my garlic has started turning slight gold, and I do not want it to turn complete gold, just a little golden. And now is the time to add my tomato. So I'm going to add in 1 diced tomato. The tomato and the green chili. I'll give it all a mix. And then start adding my dry masala. As you can see, I've added 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of paprika, and 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. I'll give it all a mix, and then I'll add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder too. You can see, invent my turmeric powder, give it all a mix, and then I'll add 1 cup of water. I will end up adding 2 more cups, so this becomes 3 cups of water in total. You can see 3 cups of water have gone in, and at this point I will wash my dal, the soaked dal, and then add it to the pressure cooker. Now in went my dal. I will pressure cook it for 20 minutes. I will now put the pressure cook lid on it, mix everything, and pressure cook it for 20 minutes, and then have a look at it. As you can see, this is what this dal looks in 20 minutes, and it is not cooked. So I'm going to add 1 cup of water and cook it for a further 20 minutes. And this dal has been cook it for a further 10 minutes. And this dal has been cooking on medium heat throughout, and it will continue cooking on medium. So in it, I'll add 1 cup of water and pressure cook it for another 10 minutes. See, the dal is now pressure cooked for the last 10 minutes, and I added 1 cup of water. You can see here I'm also making a salad, so I cut down some lettuce, and I put it in a colander. So cut it, washed it, rinse it, and so that colander helps it drain. And to this I'm going to add some chopped cucumbers. separating them. And I'm adding some chopped carrots. Now, eating of carrots, I think, is very healthy. And my family gets a push from me because I do slice them here and there and make sure that they do eat the carrots. And then I add a tomato. Now, I'm not going to add any salt to this until the time of seasoning. I'll add some salt and some lemon juice and mix everything together. Adding a chopped green chili, and this is optional. If you like it a little spicy, I did add that. So I'll be serving this salad alongside with my rice and my dal. So dal chawal and some salad. Perfect easy lunch combination. So as you can see, this is what my dal looks like at 30 minutes. It has cooked, but I can see that the chana dal are still holding their shape. I do not want them to hold shape. I want it all to be nice, mushy, and smooth. So I'm going to add another half cup of water, add some lemon juice, and check on all the seasoning and give it one more pressure, another round of pressure cooking. Now I check my salt, and my salt is cold, so I'm gonna add half cup of water and some lemon juice. So in goes my lemon juice. I'm satisfied with that. I'll also add some cilantro at this point. You can see this is what my dal now looks like. I am going to pressure cook it for a further 7 minutes. Now my dal took longer to cook because I didn't soak it for at least an hour or even half an hour. If you soak it ahead, it takes a lot lesser time. And I want my dal more on the mushier side, so I'm going to give it another 7 to 10 minutes of pressure cooking. My dal for pressure cooking for the last 7 to 10 minutes. So in goes my salad. I'm going to add some salt and some lemon juice to it. So in goes the lemon juice, and then I'll give it all mix. It's ready to serve. You want to add the lemon juice and salt towards the end to prevent the wilting of this lettuce. So enjoy this salad. As you can see, my salad is now ready to serve. Easy, simple, and tasty. Goes very well with most of the meals. So you can see it's 10 minutes now, and my pressure cooker is whistling. So the dal is ready can be. I'll switch it off. And look at it. See, the pressure has gone down. This is what the dal now officially looks like. So the grain of dal has gone soft. As I keep mixing it, it keeps breaking. And that's what I want. So now we'll serve this dal. I'll plate it up. So as you can see, this simple thali of dal, rice, and salad are ready. Do enjoy this recipe. Click on the like button, subscribe, and enjoy. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.